Every once in a while, something truly exceptional happens. A spark of genius ignites and an idea becomes reality. In 1950, that spark of genius was the formation of Uganda Clays Limited. With a focused vision of pushing the construction envelope, Uganda Clays united to demonstrate the acme of building mastery with the production of the highest quality solutions. Through the factory at Kajjansi, Uganda Clays churned out clay tiles for the upper echelon of the Ugandan population, who wanted more for themselves in terms of quality and durability of their construction materials. With the opening of another production facility in Kamonkoli, the company caused a stir within the Ugandan market and created jobs for thousands of workers to honor their legacy of fine Ugandan craftsmanship. However, due to unexpected factors, the company entered a non-profit period, halting its rise. This period saw the Uganda Clays staff stand strong and rise to the occasion by doubling their efforts in order to reclaim their prime position as pioneers at the top of the Ugandan construction food chain. The more the team worked, the more the team earned, and by their sheer force of will, the company persevered. At the dawn of its 70-year celebrations, the loyal staff of Uganda Clays remain expectant for what is to come.
In the five-year plan, as a production supervisor, I expect to increase production, to reduce on the costs, reduce on the wastes. It will lead us to achieve the 72 billion target, and in turn, the employees' remuneration will be improved.
Uganda Clays Kamonkoli is the most technologically advanced factory in East and Central Africa. Demand for our quality products is growing, yet we are producing at 50% capacity. To counter the growing demand, we have opened up outlets in Eastern, Western, and Northern Uganda. Improvements in capacity and training technical staff will enable us to satisfy the growing demand for our products coming from as far as Western Kenya.
Within the 5 years, I'm expecting machines to come on board, and these machines will drive the quality agenda heavily. Then the output of in form of products will also increase. When it comes to drying, the product drying time will be reduced from 72 hours to 24 hours. And this will, of course, go along with reducing natural drying and emphasize more of artificial drying.
Now, driven by people, processes, customers, and finance as the four pillars of the new strategy, all Uganda Clays employees are about to enjoy even more rewards as the company dives into new territory and targets 72 billion shillings turnover.
Under the new strategy, we want to enhance a performance culture, and we want to have a purpose-driven team. We are going to focus basically on two things. One, enhance knowledge and skills, and at the same time, make sure that you are engaged. An engaged employee is the best for the organization, because when you do a job with passion and love, you are able to put your best foot forward so that we are able to deliver value to the customers whom we serve. The focus is going to be on attracting, retaining, and motivating the best employees. We must become the employer of choice in the next 5 years.
We intend to grow our revenue by double, because right now we are doing slightly over 30 billion. We want to have achieved 72 billion by 2023. But at the same time, we want to be able to do this efficiently. We want to reduce our wastage significantly. For us to do that, it means we are offering better customer service internally and externally. But at the same time, as staff, we are fully engaged so that we enjoy our jobs and we are doing the best of what we are expected of. We need to constantly monitor performance to say we are on track or we are not on track. So we are going to leverage ICT to be able to do that. When we grow our revenue and reduce our costs, that means there's more profit and there's more to share with shareholders. If we have a target to grow revenue, it's not a target for the sales team or the production team. Whether I'm someone who cleans the offices, or a clinic officer who treats people, or the person responsible for making sure that our internet is on all the time, we have a direct relationship with growing revenue and reducing cost.
In our 5-year plan, technology will be key. We plan on importing state-of-the-art machinery. We plan on installing fine milling machines that will ensure high-quality finished product. The finishing will be smooth. The quality will be far much ahead of competition. Special products ordered by the customer will be provided within the shortest time possible. Out of stocks will be something of the past.
With this 5-year strategy, we are going online and the customers will be able to order from wherever they are. And once we confirm the transactions online, then they will be able to access our products from any outlets across the country. And this will improve on the turnaround time for customers doing business with us.
In the course of last year, both board and management took up some valuable time to reflect on the performance of the business over the past couple of years. The business convened and developed a new vision of being the leading local brand for building solutions. We feel that this is a compelling vision, which I think if we really articulated it and actually implemented it, it will go a long way in turning the fortunes of our company. For us to be in a position to do this also, the business had to develop a new mission, which is driving radical improvements in building solutions through simplicity, through convenience and quality. To enable this, the business developed 4 pillars which will guide our operations into the next 5 years. Number one is one where we are going to grow our revenues from the current 30 billion shillings annually to 72 billion shillings. The second pillar of our business is one of people agenda. I'd like to share with you that currently we estimate that our staff engagement is in the region of 50 to 55%. Our plan by 2023 is to hit a staff engagement of approximately 80%. The third pillar is one of the net promoter score, where the number of customers who basically make referrals or make recommendations for customers to buy from us is currently very low. We estimate that it's about 55%. We'd like to move that number to about 90%. The last pillar, our wastage levels are in the region of 25%. We think this wastage can improve on it. We'd like to, by 2023, to drop this wastage to about 5%.